What's going on today, guys? I'm Taylor, and this is Southern Hike. We got a great video today talking about what's the best way to carry your water with backpacking. So join along and let's figure it out. You know, everybody knows when you go backpacking, you want to know how much water do I need to carry, how will I carry it, and then how much weight is it going to take to carry it. Now, a common thing a lot of people don't know about is that your actual bottle can be a lot of your weight. Let's take, for example, this Nalgene bottle. Two of these ends up being almost a pound. It's technically right around 13 ounces. So you don't even think about this. This empty bottle is almost a half pound. So it's something very much to keep in mind. And when you empty both of these, you're still carrying a pound of weight. So this is not always the best choice. It's always, you know, important to remember that on a day hike, weight is not as big of an issue, but if you're hiking 3 or 4 days or even an overnight, if you're doing 10 to 15 miles up to 30 to 40, you don't want to carry a lot of extra weight that you're not going to need and it's just wearing you down. So it's always important to cut off those extra pounds of any kind of weight you don't need, even down to the ounces. So remember that. This is one of the heaviest ones to pick. I use it for day hikes. Me and Rachel do like them. They're super tough, but they also can be heavy, heavy bottles. And I know there's a lot of hikers out there that refuse to even use them. So what I want to talk about today is your options. Now there's a lot of options out there. I don't have a lot of them on this table today, but it's important to know that there is some simple options to think of. So on a day hike, I recommend these bottles. They're not that heavy for a day hike. I mean, you think about a half pound, we're not really worried about that. So when I carry my day pack, I can carry two of these and then have a half gallon of water. These both hold, I mean, two of these will hold 32 ounces apiece. So it's important to know that this is capable easily for a day hike, especially in the hot summer. But if I'm going on an overnight hike, or if I'm doing a 2 or 3 day hike, it's important to kind of cut down every ounce you can to keep that weight down, especially if you're doing a very high incline hike. We've got a couple big hikes coming up later this summer that we want to make sure that we keep every bit of weight we don't need out of the way. So something we use for something like that is just like a smart water bottle. Now this actually empty is right over an ounce. So you think about that. This right here weighs 6 of these. So keep that, you know, think about how much weight you're actually carrying. And these bottles, the smart water bottles, that's why I like them, they're tough. I mean, this can handle a lot of pressure on it. So this can be an alternate choice. Now you gotta have a pack that will actually, you can stick them in and make sure that they will stay secure. But most backpacks are deep enough on the sides with the pockets to be able to stick this in and to hold secure. And in some packs, you can stick two of these on one side so you can carry even more water, but you're also adding to your weight. So that's something important to keep in mind. And then the other option is a small, typical, where you buy at Walmart or any super grocery store or anything, is these small 16 ounce bottles. Now this is half the amount of water that can be carried as this bottle. You know, this bottle here can carry double what this can, but this weighs like less than a quarter of an ounce. So you now the have two of these or two of these, you would need 4 of these bottles. So you're still like an ounce in total weight in plastic to carry your water. That is something that's awesome to be able to know. But these bottles tear up really easy and start leaking. So this bottle is done already. So, and another thing is you find these on the trail, do not leave these on the trail. This is plastic. It'll be stuck in the woods forever, and it is not good for nature or the environment, and it's very important that we take care of our earth. So do not leave these thrown away on the trail. It drives me and Rachel crazy when we find these on the trail. So you need to leave with no trace. That's always an important rule to live by when hiking and backpacking. Don't leave these on the trail. But this is an option if you carry it out with you. It's a lot less weight. If you're gonna make sure you're not gonna damage this, you know, slinging it around, throwing your pack down, you don't wanna bust this open, because once it's busted, it's just a big leak anyways and it's no use. Another option is a bladder. Now this is actually the Sawyer filtration system bladder. There's tons of bladders on Amazon and eBay. You know, REI has a great selection. You can carry a bladder. These are about the same weight, just barely any weight at all. So it's something to keep in mind that you can use these. I don't particularly like them. I just don't like all the flexing. I kind of like a solid structure for carrying my water, but I keep this on me for my filtration system. I'm gonna be doing a video on this, so make sure to check up at the top to click on the video. Soon there's going to be a video for this and how great these are for filtering your water. We use these all the time. Sawyer makes a great kit, and honestly, they've helped me out. When I lost a piece for mine, they sent me a piece for free very quickly. I had it in 3 days, so be looking out for that video. And then another option is a life straw. You just carry this alone. Now it has to be a hike when you got water available. And you know, some places, you know, some really bad mud might be full of dirt, so it's not a good option to use this because it would just fill with dirt and clog up on you. And the same with the Sawyer one, you gotta clean it. But for the most part, you know, you can get a good bit of filtered water out of it without dealing with an issue. So this is another option though. This weighs very little. All you would carry with this is on a day hike. If you know you're going to be around some creeks, it'll be a perfect thing to keep with you. If you need to get a drink of water, you know it's important in the hot summer to make sure you're keeping tons of water with you though. So you're going to need to find, be around a lot of creeks to be able to keep hydrated. So it's not always a viable option, but if you just want to carry maybe one bottle and one of these, it works great too. And to go along with that, with the Sawyer kit, you know, you can carry this, and this actually, well, I don't have the actual adapter on it right now, but this actually will fit on top of here, and you can use this to filter your water, you know, if you want to pour more out of the creek. And then you can use a bladder if you want to actually attach this and squeeze it in there. Be watching out for that video because I'll explain more of how to use this kit and what it comes with. So these are your options. It's always important to keep those in mind of what you're going to be carrying with you and how to keep that weight down. If you're an ultralight packer and you don't want to be carrying a bunch of weight, don't bring these with you. They're very heavy. So it's something to always be aware of. They are great bottles. These are actually the REI version of them. You can get them in different designs. If you've seen in some of our videos, we have used some different designs, and it's something just to remember that they're a great option if you want to use those. But these smart water bottles, they don't make you smarter, just FYI, but they do have, if you buy the actual bottle already full of water, it has a good electrolyte supply for minerals in the water, so that's something you can bring with you. If you're picking them up on the way, if you're flying across country and you don't wanna have to bring extra stuff with you or take up room, so you can just buy these in any convenience store or any grocery store, they're an awesome option to have. And I mean, also with these too, you can pick these up anywhere. I don't really recommend this option. It's just too easy for these to get messed up and leak. And I mean, once you drink one, if you squeeze it, you know, it loses its integrity. So it's not a good option. But there's a lot of other options out there. You know, check online. There's a lot of bladders you can use like this to carry your water in. A lot of them actually fold up when there's no water in them, so you can keep them that way too. But, and then another way is to keep an actual bladder on your back that goes in your pack. I have one. I'll use them on a day hike, but for multiple days, honestly, as they're full of water, they can kind of swell up, so they arch into my back. So it defeats the purpose, honestly, to me of using my backpack or my day pack, both my Osprey packs. I don't really like them that much. They are convenient because you always have your water right there. You don't have to worry about, and you can carry extra stuff in your side. Netting on the side of your pack, so that's another option to think about too. That's all I got today. I really hope you enjoyed this video. Make sure to comment any suggestions, any questions you have. Make sure to subscribe. Guys, the subscription is so important to us to keep these videos up and to make sure you're enjoying the content and we can bring you more content. We thank you for everyone that subscribed so far. Make sure to like this video if you enjoyed it. And again, make sure to comment. We thank you for everything and hope you have a great day.